story today? Oh, well, that's wonderful, because I brought with me my most favorite story. It's called Aladdin, and it is about the most amazing adventure. Does that sound interesting? Oh, well, good, because today you and I are going to take a journey to Agrabah.
Salam and good evening to you, worthy friends. Welcome to the fabled city of Agrabah, city of flying carpets, soaring heroes, famous low ballads, and more glitz and glamour than any other fictional city in the world. Oh, I come from a land, from a faraway place, where the caravan camels roam, where it's flat and immense, and the heat is intense. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home. When the wind's from the east, and the sun's from the west, and the sand in the glass is right, come on down, step on by, hop a carpet and fly to another Arabian night. And of course, you know what Agrabah's famous for, this magical land. Don't be fooled by its commonplace appearance. Like so many things, it is not what's on the outside, but what's on the inside that counts. Whoa, got a little deep there for a second. This lamp put Agrabah on the map. You've never been? Well, we can fix that.
Thank you.
about that lamp. That lamp is the start of our story about Aladdin. There's a peddler in Agrabah who can tell us all about it.
Welcome to Agrabah, city of mystery. I can see that you're only interested in the exceptionally rare. I think then you'll be most rewarded to consider this. Do not be fooled by his commonplace appearance. Like so many things, it is not what is outside, but what is inside that counts. This is no ordinary lamp! It once changed the course of a young man's life. A young man who liked this lamp was more than what he seemed. A diamond in the rough.
We must go back to a dark night in the desert just outside of Agrabah. Jafar, the advisor to the Sultan, is leading a thief to the entrance of the Cave of Wonders, an underground treasure chest full of more gold and jewels than you could ever dream of. Jafar wants to find the lamp hidden deep in the cave, but the guardian of the cave says the thief is not worthy to enter. Jafar needs to find the diamond in the rough, a street urchin named Aladdin, who's just trying to get some breakfast. Hiding in the alley. Minutes later, Aladdin and Abu leave the alley and see the same children about to get run over by a prince's horse. Aladdin saves the children, but angers the prince, who calls him a worthless street rat and slams the palace doors in Aladdin's face. Upset, Aladdin goes to his hidden rooftop home and tells Abu that somehow he's going to become someone special.
Riffraff, street rat, I don't buy that. If only they'd look closer, would they see a poor boy? No, sweet. They'd find out there's so much more to me.
I'm gonna become somebody. I don't know how exactly, but I am. I have to. Somehow.
Proud of your boy. I'll make you proud of your boy. Believe me, that I've been off. You're in for a pleasant surprise. I've wasted time. I've wasted me. So say I'm slow for my age. A late bloomer. Some pride and some joy, but I'll get over these lousing up, messing up, screwing up times. You'll see, ma, now comes the better part. Someone's gonna make good, cross your stupid heart, make good and finally make you proud of me. No good, but that could be all that I am. Waterfalls on the bridge, let it pass, let it go. There's no good reason that you should believe, not yet. I know, but someday and soon, I'll make you proud of your boy. Though I can't make myself taller or smarter or handsome or wise. I wasn't born perfect like Dad or you. Mom, I will try hard to make you proud of your boy.
Made fun of Aladdin, who's going to the palace to meet Princess Jasmine. She must marry a prince before her birthday, but none of the princes she's met have been right. This prince is no different. Jasmine sends him away. The Sultan, Jasmine's father, explains to her why she must marry a prince. Unable to convince her, he asks Jafar for help. Meanwhile, Jasmine decides to sneak out of the palace and go to the marketplace, where Aladdin saves her from an angry vendor and takes her to his rooftop home.
Dearest, you've got to stop rejecting every suitor who comes to call. The law says you must be married to a prince by your next birthday.
The law is wrong.
You've only got 3 more days.
Father, please, try to understand. I've never done a thing on my own. I've never had any real friends. Except you, Raja. I've never even been outside the palace walls.
But Jasmine, you're a princess.
Then maybe I don't want to be a princess anymore.
I don't know where she gets it from. Her mother was amused at Kiki. Ooh, ah, Jeff. Tefard, my most trusted advisor. I am in desperate need of your wisdom.
My life is but to serve you, my lord.
It's this suitor business. Jasmine refuses to choose a husband. I'm at my wit's end.
Perhaps I can divine a solution to this thorny problem.
This is your first time in the marketplace, huh?
Isn't that obvious?
Well, you do kind of stand out. I mean, you don't seem to know how dangerous Agrabah can be.
I'm a fast learner.
Come on, this way.
Jasmine is sent back to the palace, but Aladdin and Abu are sent to the dungeon. Jasmine goes to Jafar to free Aladdin, but Jafar lies and tells her that Aladdin was sentenced to death. Princess Jasmine leaves crying, not knowing that Aladdin is actually still alive in the dungeons. Jafar, knowing Aladdin is the diamond in the rough needed to enter the Cave of Wonders, convinces him to go into the cave and fetch the lamp. What's happening is real, so the genie decides to give Aladdin a little explanation.
Time is your restaurant.
While Aladdin and Abu are meeting the genie in the Cave of Wonders, Jafar returns to the palace and consults with his parrot Iago. They come up with a plan that will make Jafar the Sultan of Agrabah without the lamp. Jafar can marry Jasmine, because she hasn't found a prince to marry yet, and then Jafar will become Sultan and rule Agrabah. They think it's a brilliant plan, but what Jafar and Iago don't know is that Aladdin is about to tell the genie his first wish.
So what'll it be, Matthew?
You're gonna grant me any three wishes I want, right? I don't know, Abu. You probably can't even get us out of this cave. Looks like we're gonna have to find a way out.
Excuse me? Are you looking at me? Did you rub my lamp? Did you wake me up? Did you bring me here? And all of a sudden you're walking out on me? I don't think so. Not right now. You're getting your wishes, so sit down!
In case of emergency, the exits are here.
Anywhere!
Keep your hands and arms inside the carpet, please.
Wishes. Just my ears deceive me. Three? You are down by one!
No, I never actually wished to get out of the cave. You did that on your own.
Why a free wish?
All right, bad boy. But no more freebies.
Fair deal. So, three wishes. I want them to be good. What would you wish for?
Me? No one's ever asked me that before.
Well, in my case,
forget it.
What? Come on, tell me.
Freedom.
You're a prisoner?
It's all part and parcel of the whole genie gig.
Hey, can you make me a prince?
Oh, let's see. Aha, to make a prince.
Now, is that an official wish?
Say the magic words.
Genie, I wish for you to make me a prince.
All right!
Boom! Suddenly, Aladdin is no longer a street urchin, but Prince Ali of Bagua. Now, he has a chance to marry Princess Jasmine, whom he fell in love with while they were at his rooftop home. Back at the palace, Jafar is telling the Sultan he could marry Jasmine if no other suitors arrive. The Sultan isn't so sure because the law says the princess must marry a prince. But Jafar puts the Sultan under a spell. The Sultan has almost promised to let Jafar marry Jasmine when they hear trumpets in the distance, welcoming a new prince to town.
Bizarre.
And you!
Let us move, it's a brand new star. Oh, come be the first on your rock to meet his eye. Medway, here he comes, ring bell, bang the drum. I hear on a lot of their star. Prince Ali, fabulously, Ali of Bagua. Can you flex, show some respect, now the money. Now try your best to take off. Brush up your Sunday salon.
He's got
people as one. He got down, up and rock on.
Ali is allowed to enter the palace. He meets the Sultan and Jafar, who have watched the whole parade from the balcony. The Sultan is thrilled to meet Aladdin because he thinks they may have just found the prince who will be able to win over Jasmine's heart.
Your Majesty, I have journeyed from afar to seek your daughter's hand.
Prince Ali Baba, of course, I'm delighted to meet you. This is my royal vizier, Jafar. He's delighted too.
Ecstatic.
If we're lucky, you won't have to marry Jasmine after all.
I don't trust him, sire.
Nonsense. One thing I pride myself on, Jafar, I'm an excellent judge of character. Jasmine will like this one.
And I'm pretty sure I'll like Princess Jasmine.
No, I must intercede on Jasmine's behalf. This boy is no different from the others. What makes him think he is worthy of a princess?
Your Majesty, I am Prince Ali Baba. Just let her meet me. I will win your daughter.
How dare you? All of you, standing around deciding my future? I am not a prize to be won.
Right, Sparky, here's the deal. If you want to court the little lady, you gotta be a straight shooter, do you got it?
What?
Tell her the truth!
No way! If Jasmine found out I was really some crummy street rat, she'd laugh at me.
A woman appreciates a man in a bigger life.
Al, all joking aside, you really ought to be yourself.
Hey, that's the last thing I want to be. Okay. I'm gonna go see her. I gotta be smooth, cool, confident. How do I look?
Like a prince.
Who's there?
It's me, Prince Ali.
Prince Ali Ababwa.
I do not want to see you.
No, please, Princess, give me a chance.
Just leave me alone.
Calm down.
Wait. Do I know you?
No.
You remind me of someone I met in the marketplace.
The marketplace? I have servants who go to the marketplace for me. You don't want to go for a ride, do you? We could get out of the palace, see the woman.
Is it safe?
Sure, do you trust me?
What?
Do you trust me?
Yes.
Smiling, Princess Jasmine climbs onto the magic carpet with Prince Ali. She doesn't know that he is the boy she met at the marketplace. Together, they fly across the world, exploring cities they'd only heard of, and slowly but surely falling more and more in love with each other.
I can show you the world. Shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride. A whole new world, a new fantastic mystic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
Vile betrayer!
Exalted vile betrayer to you!
see about that.
Land. Finders keepers.
I order you to stop.
Ah, but there's a new order now. My order. Finally, you will bow to me.
We will never bow to you.
If you will bow before a sultan,
then you will cower before a sorcerer.
Genie, my second wish.
I wish to be the most powerful sorcerer in the world.
Thank you.
Bling and Jafar long gone, Aladdin is still upset. He summons his courage and decides to finally apologize for not telling Jasmine the truth sooner. Luckily, he finds both the princess and her father to be very forgiving.
Jasmine, I'm sorry I lied to you about being a prince.
I know why you did.
Well, I guess this is goodbye.
Oh, that stupid law. This isn't fair. I love you.
Al, no problem. You still got one wish left.
Just say the word and you're a prince again.
But Genie, what about your freedom?
Hey, it's only an eternity of servitude.
Genie, I wish for your freedom.
One bona fide prince pedigree coming up.
Genie, you're free. I'm free.
I'm free.
Quick, quick. Wish for something outrageous, say. I want the Nile. Wish for the Nile. Try that.
I wish for the Nile.
No way!
You've certainly proven your worth as far as I'm concerned. It's that law that's the problem.
Father?
Well, am I sultan or am I sultan? From this day forth, the princess shall marry whoever she deems worthy.
Him, I choose you, Aladdin.
Call me Al.
Whatever he wishes. Aladdin, even though he's not a prince, can marry Jasmine. The Sultan gets to see his daughter wed and happy. It's a whole new world for our heroes in Agrabah, and what a wonderful one it is too. The genie, Aladdin, Jasmine, Abu, the Sultan, and all the citizens of Agrabah are going to live happily ever after.
Right. So long, worthy friend, come back soon. Let's get it.
I'm afraid I don't have time to tell you another story today, but if you come back next year, I'm sure you and I will see each other again very soon.